So today, Better Living Education channel, we are with us students of the Department of Law, University of Mumbai, specializing in diploma in alternate dispute resolution, a very emerging area. And I also welcome Professor Srikant Ojha, who has taken all the initiative in organizing the discussion, a small discussion in this our Better Living channel. I want to discuss about why the students joined the course, what are their perception, what are their suggestions, what benefits they are going to get, what are the future opportunities in particular area of ADR, and many other what are their own ideas, personal ideas. So I think all these things briefly we'll discuss in this small discussion of the Better Living channel. So thank you, Professor Srikant Ojha, and now we'll start with the discussion. So first, I will start with Professor Srikant Ojha. Sir, why? What is your? What is the concept of the ADR?
Sir, ADR basic is it's a way to settle the matter between the two disputed party, and this is not the new concept. It's an old concept. Prior to this, the word ADR came into existence. We had the Gram Panchayat system, which was basically it's an ADR, and it was working as a jury, and they were trying to solving the problem. Now suppose if any person comes to us from the other fields, he will definitely ask for his own terms and conditions. Therefore, the word ADR came into existence from 1940. The Britishers has amended this act, and in 1996, this act came into existence because of the WTO.
Okay. So, thank you, Professor Ojha, for clarifying this concept. And I think you are nicely explained in briefly the concept of ADR. Now, I'll coming to students of this diploma courses. And I request them to introduce themselves and then highlight about why they want to join this particular course and what are the future opportunities in this particular area of ADR.
I am Sanjay Zawde, and it is apparent that the judicial system in this country is clogged with cases, and it is taking tremendous time to resolve disputes, and therefore more and more people are resorting to alternative dispute resolution methods, especially in the commercial field. And therefore, this is a growing field. The government has made and amended laws for faster resolution of disputes. And therefore, there is a lot of scope for there. And it is also, I thought, my duty to contribute towards resolving disputes and learning the systems which are parallel to the law.
Do you think actually this concept is being actually applied by the institutions or the government in settling the dispute?
Yes, definitely, because in commercial matters more and more disputes are being taken for arbitration and things like that, and very lesser and lesser people are going for the court system. But some more things will have to be, some improvements will have to be done, but I am sure it will catch up, for sure.
So thank you. And I just want to ask you a question. How you feel that this ADR concept or the system is important in this Indian context? Now we'll carry on, and the next students will enlighten us about this concept. Thank you.
Sir, judicial process में ये जो ADR होता है, उसके अंदर दो पार्टी के थ्रू से मध्यस्थता करने का काम ADR के थ्रू हो रहा है. और आज के जमाने में ADR को ज्यादा महत्व प्रदान कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि एज हम लोग एक एडवोकेट के पास जाते हैं तो बहुत समय जाता है, लेकिन यही चीज ADR के पास जाने के बाद जो भी मैटर होता है वो जल्दी से जल्दी क्लोज होता है. और यही मतलब ये बहुत अच्छा है।
आप एडीआर का जो कोर्स किया तो उसका आपको क्या, उसका कुछ करियर में कुछ एडवांसमेंट होने वाला है कि भाई कि फ्रीलांस करके जस्ट नॉलेज पॉइंट से आपने किया, क्या उद्देश्य है आपका?
मेरा तो नॉलेज पॉइंट से मैंने किया था इसके अंदर मैंने कि ये बहुत आगे, जैसे बिस्लरी का जब भी इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ था इंडिया में तभी हमारे यहाँ पे बोला था कि ये बिस्लरी जो बॉटल दे रहे जो 20 रुपीज में वो नहीं चलेगा। तो जो क्योंकि ये भारत में अगर हम किसी दुश्मन के घर पे भी जाते हैं तो जब पानी मांगते हैं तो फ्री में देता है, तो जो एडीआर जो जो बिस्लरी है वो एज अ कोई भी आदमी खरीदेगा नहीं जो किसी से भी है, लेकिन जो लॉन्ग टाइम के लिए सोचा उसने उसने जो बिस्लरी जो कंसेप्ट निकाला वो लॉन्ग टाइम के बारे में सोचा और आज सक्सेसफुल के रास्ते पे है। वैसे ही आज एडीआर भी है, आज लोग इसके पे ध्यान नहीं दे रहे लेकिन लॉन्ग टाइम के लिए ये एडीआर सबसे महत्वपूर्ण है क्योंकि ये जल्दी से जल्दी मैटर क्लोज करने में उपयोगी होता है।
अच्छा अच्छा, आपका और एक विद्यार्थी अपने साथ में है जो लॉ डिपार्टमेंट में डिप्लोमा का कोर्स कर रहे हैं, तो हम उनसे पूछना चाहते हैं कि करियर ऑप्शंस के लिए, करियर अपॉर्चुनिटी से ये कोर्स का क्या फायदा रहेगा, आपका सजेशंस क्या है कि इसके क्या इंप्रूवमेंट होना चाहिए प्रैक्टिकली से ऐसा आपको लगता है? आपका नाम बताइए प्लीज।
माय नेम इज नेबिल, आई एम ऑलरेडी वर्किंग इन अ कंपनी एंड आई हैव बीन एसोसिएटेड विद आर्बिट्रेशन टू अ ग्रेट एक्सटेंट इन माय कंपनी। नाउ व्हाट आई फील इज दैट इट्स अ वेरी गुड ऑल्टरनेट डिस्प्यूट रेजोल्यूशन प्रोसेस दैट इज अवेलेबल टू अस बिकॉज नंबर वन there is no appeal there once it is decided between the by the arbitrator, unless that arbitrator has faulted on law points. But as far as merit is concerned, there is no question of it being contested. And if this sort of a thing is properly executed, then there are chances that disputes could get resolved quickly. People will start having more faith in the system, and it could also be least expensive because in normal court where matters are contested you have appeals at various stages which go right from the lower court to Supreme Court, and because of the pendency of cases that are lying in various courts it takes years for justice to come in. And as you find that over a period of time you feel people retire and go but the disputes are still not settled. So ADR is a very good thing. Only thing is we are at a very nascent stage in India and there are a lot of things.
Any suggestions from your point? Any suggestions?
Suggestion is yes. I personally feel from my experiences, first it should be made cost effective. Because today arbitration I think is always looked as a very expensive process. Where a common person cannot go to.
True.
So that concept should, means a concept should come where you limit that cost, number one. Number two, there is a system that needs to be laid down because today, procedurally, the arbitrator is free to adopt his own system of arbitrating the matter. And if that is laid down properly, then even the little bit of appeal that is left can also be overcome.
So I think you have made valid suggestions, and let us see that if government or channel goes to the government officers and the authorities, we expect and hope that they will take into consideration your suggestions, which are really valid. Anything, any suggestion from your point of view?
Sir, as we all know that we are approaching towards balanced life, and I think ADR is something which provides you balanced approach to solve your disputes. So today people are not aware about more about ADR, but in future people, as far as they will come to know, they will approach towards balanced approach and they will solve their issues through amicably in ADR procedure.
So I think it was really a very live discussion, and students are looking forward for some changes and in this particular area of the ADR, which is really a very meaningful, a very effective area, and I think it's a need of the hour considering lot of pendency of the cases in this particular area, and so many in India there are more than 3 crores of the cases are pending in various courts, And in civil cases, at least it takes 10 years, and criminal cases, at least 5 years to settle or decide their particular matter. And then again, there is a procedure of the appeal going on like that. So, considering all these procedure delays in this country and the delay in giving the pendency of the cases, I think ADR is really a very emerging area, very meaningful and effective area. And if all these suggestions given by the students who are specializing in that particular area, the government and authority concerns should take into consideration, and really it will have a very fruitful, and really it will have at least a discussion. Government will be benefited because of the suggestions coming out of the small and brief suggestion. Now, we're coming to the professor concluding this discussion. I am coming to the Professor Oza. So, I just want to conclude and ask from Mr. Oza, sir, how we'll conclude this discussion from the various suggestions given by the students. And what you perceive, your personal comments, sir?
Yes. Now it is very essential. It is very essential that one should go for the ADR in any matter. I mean, either it is a small matter or the big matter. Previously, the same system which we had. Now we have the refined way of ADR method. So we must accept it. And because of that, the world is in digital age. So we should not time into say thing from our what point of view, but we should think from the WTO point of view. Then only we will survive. Now the reason behind this ADR is because you know that for when foreigners are coming to the India, how to solve their problems. So therefore the recent government has taken the steps that single window systems. What is single window systems? I mean to say this is the great change which he has bring for their comfort and the convenience, so they can come to the India and we can be financially developed, we become the developing country. So, sir, thank you very much for being with us, and I am thankful to Yende sir, and he highly respectable person for us, not for me, but for our group and for our Bombay University also. And after his retirement, sir, his movement is an excellent, and which is beyond the words, and we pray God that always you be successful and proceed just like anything. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Oza. And I think this was really a great initiative by Professor Oza along with the students of the department. And again, thanking you, and looking forward some other type of the another discussion on any emerging area. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.